So today in this video, we'll learn how to make like these type of login pages using Elementor Pro and another plugin that name is Pwnnet. This plugin, Pwnnet add-on. This is a pro plugin. So we need two plugin. One is Elementor and another is Pwnnet add-on. Okay. So basically, this plugin is if you search on Google, then we'll find out it. Okay, just search it. Basically, I'm talking about like this plugin. If you see here, like Pwnnet add-on for Elementor, like this plugin. Install this plugin. Basically, I'm using this pro version. So if you are interested to update this, you can update. Okay. So I'm going to my admin panel, and here, as you can see, all page. Just click on this add new page and click create a new page. I already created a new page. That's why I just not create again a new page. Okay, so when you create a new page, then you will see a page like this, and here the plus icon, click on here, and here the section, create an one section, two column, and okay, first we need to type this title. So drag and drop and title here and paste it, click on the style, then change the color, text color. I'm using black color, and here the typography, select this cabin, like this cabin, and here click on EM and change it to 2.7. it's looking fine. And here line height, we need to change the line height. Okay, that's 1.2, it's looking fine. And here you'll see this email address field, and here password box, and here remember me, and here forget password. So first we need to add the email address like field or box. Okay, so we need to find out here these add-on like Pwnnet free widgets. Okay, here as you can see, this Pwnnet from builder, like this option here, find out, or search here field, here search here field, FIE here, as you can see, field. So drag and drop this. Okay, just simply drag and drop here like this. One another thing, just click on this section, and here as you can see, this height fit to screen, set up this fit to screen, then you will see this content are now middle. Okay, so click on again this pane icon, then you will see this here one option, the field option. Okay, so we need to add on field option. So I just input here like field name is login underscore custom. Okay, so I just input custom, just CUS custom O. Okay, like this. And again we need to field id, which are field id. So I need to add one login underscore or this email. Okay, and we need to change this type. I'm selecting here email, and here as you can see the label. So I just input here one label, email address, and this is record. So click on this, then you will see like this type of page now, this type of box. So again duplicate this, and we need to change, don't change this form ID, because here I'm using email address, password, remember login, same form ID, because they are located in one form. Okay, they're located in one form, you see here. Okay, so we need to change this in login pass, change this, and I'm changing here the label, password, input this password, and we need to record, select this record. Okay, if you want to add any placeholder, you can do this, or if you don't want to add this, it's your wish. So again I need to add one like this remember me button. Okay, I just duplicate this password, and then I just click on here. Okay, I need to change one thing here. Click on this password and I need to change this type password. Okay, I change this password again. I just click on this password new box, and here as you can see, I need to change this type, change here this checkbox, because as if you see here, this is a checkbox. Client or in a person, click on here and click on this login button. Basically this is checkbox. Okay, so we need to change this option. So I don't need any kind of label here, just input here remember me. I just copy here this and off this, turn off this show label, then you'll see it's off, and paste here this option, then we'll see the remember me. And we need to add again the forget password. Okay, so again I just go to here and find out here like lost password, drag and drop here again. Okay, then you'll see like this type of page. So I want to change this text like forget password, forget password. Okay, it's looking now fine. And we are using one basic tools or widgets, that is inner section. I just drag and drop here and drag this, drag to drop in there, and one thing, forget password. Okay, it's looking now fine. And again I need to add one submit button. Basically this is login button, so I need to add one submit button. So again go to this PAFE, like this PAFE form builder, and here as you can see this submit button. So drag and drop here. Okay, fine. Then you will see like this type of page, and sorry, as you can see, so I need to change this text. I need to input like submit, and alignment I don't change here, anything else here. And again here you can see this submit after, like this here. Okay, this is action after submit. Login here, input login, submit login, and redirect. Basically I want to login when any user click on this button, then will they are redirect to another my account page, and they are login. Okay, so we need to here as you can see this username or email field shortcode. So we need to copy this shortcode and click on this remember me, and we need to check everything fine or not fine. As you can see, we're not changing here this remember me, so we need to change this remember me. Okay, and checkbox, it's right now. And again just go to this email box, then you will see here the shortcode. Just copy this and go to your button, and here paste here again, click on this password button and copy this shortcode again, go to your button, then paste here again. I just go to this checkbox and copy this shortcode, go to your button, then paste here. Okay, it's done now. As you can see here our button color, so I click on this color picker and click on this button, then we'll see, because we need to copy this color. So copy to clipboard, go to my element here and click on this button, click on the style, and here as you can see this type of, okay, this is background color, and paste here. Okay, that's, then we'll see this, it's changed. Okay, and we need to add another button, that means register button. So again I just go to here and we need to drag and drop one normal button. So drag and drop here. Again, we need to add in a simple inner section. So drag and drop this inner section. Okay, and drag and drop here the, and click on this button and style, go to this background color button and change the background color, and again click on this pin button and click on this advance. I need to change this, like click on this percent and link, remove link and minus 30-40%. Okay, as you can see it's looking now like this. Okay, so we need to design this email box and password field. So first click on this email account button, click on this style, then click on this field. So we need to change this box background color. Okay, so first we need, click on this color picker and copy this color, copy to clipboard, and here as you can see the background, just click on here and paste your recent copied background color. Okay, then you will see the changes. Okay, again we need to remove this border. So if you want to remove this border, so find out here like this border type solid, and remove the link and bottom 1 pixel, then you'll see the changes. Okay, it's looking now like this. Okay, I just click on this, click on mouse right button, then you'll show the copy button, and here as you can see paste style, then you will see the changes. Okay, it's changed. So we need to add one padding, like click on this column and advance, and here as you can see this padding, so I just select some percent padding and put here like 8% it's looking now fine. And again just click on this column and click on this style and find out border. Here as you can see this box color, so here the box color, if you want to add any particular color, so you can do this, or if you want to add if you want to change anything, that means if you look here, like it's looking now official, it's looking fine. And we need to add this monkey. So how you can add this, I'll provide this monkey Lottie file in video description, like JSON file, so download this if you were like this monkey, and find out here like Lottie. Okay, Lottie, I just install this Elementor kit, that's why I just created this Lottie add-on. I just drag and drop here and click on this plus icon, and you need to upload this 10 or a JSON file, and then we'll see here this. Okay, and if you see here, and this not looking now good, so again I just click on this column and layout vertical middle, then we'll see the changes. Okay, so it's looking now fine. I really like this. As you can see, we need to change the height, like bottom height here. So I just click on this section, inner section, and advance, click on this link value, click on percent top, like 5 or 3 or 4, like 4, it's look fine. Okay, it's looking fine, and click on this update, then we'll save. Okay, and we need to check this, it's responsive or not responsive. I just click on this responsive mode and then we'll select the mobile, then you'll see it's not responsive, so we need to change it. Okay, so click on this pen icon, then typography, and we need to change this size, so that's why I just input like 2 em, and it's not looking good. Okay, or 1.5 is looking fine, and we need to change the line height into 1.3. okay, it's good. Okay, and as you can see this is remember me and forget password, so we need to change this. I want to click on this button, then we'll click on this style here, center or right. Okay, it's looking fine. Again just click on here, that means login register button, select the right. Okay, then we'll see the changes. or if you remove or don't remove anything here, okay, we need to change this text register. Okay, it's looking now fine. Okay, and if you want to add any kind of box shadow, it's looking very nice. I just add in a box shadow. Again, go to this, and here, as you can see, this box shadow. So it's looking nice. Okay, so if you want to add any motion effect here, you can use it. Okay, how we can use the motion effect? I just click on this column, then click on this advanced button. And here, as you can see, this motion effect, I just select here default to left, and here the monkey. I just click on this column and find out. Okay, so click on this advanced button, find out motion effect, and here the animation. I just select here like right. Okay, it's looking good. I just click on this update button, then we'll see the changes. Okay, if I reload my website, then we'll see the changes. Wow, that's great. If you want to add the particular button in motion effect, you can do this. So I go to here and select one button and go to the advanced section and find out here like motion effect. And here, as we can see, this animation, I just click and I'll just select here like this and register button. Click on register button, advance, and motion effect animation, right? Okay, it's looking, I think it's looking fine. Okay, again I just go to my website and reload this, then you will see the changes. Wow, if you want to add any kind of mouse effect here, you can do this. Just click on this motion effect and mouse effect if you want to add like this. So you can do this. Okay, it's looking fine now. Okay, okay, click on this update button. Okay, thanks for watching this video. If you like this video, click on this like button, or if you are new here in my channel, so please subscribe. Wait for the next video. Next video will show, I'll show you how to create and register page, and then next video I'll show you on a switch page, like one page, like a switch page. Okay, login and register one page.